Hello students, welcome again. In our previous lecture, we described a little bit about the endocrine system, and in today's topic, today's lecture, we will be discussing about the endocrine system in detail. Now, what do we mean by the endocrine system? As the name indicates, this is a system, and as you know, a system is an organ system. This is an organ system. System also shock organ system also, and here endocrine system, this is the system, this is an organ system which is composed of the endocrine glands, and these endocrine glands, they secrete the chemical substances. The chemical substances are known as hormones into the blood because they do not contain the ducts, and for passage into the target organs where they control and coordinate the various activities of the target organs. This is the definition of the endocrine glands. Endocrine system, it is the system of endocrine glands which secrete the chemical substances known as hormones into the blood to reach the target organs, where they control and coordinate the various activities of the target organs. This is the definition. And after that, now the question arises, what are the hormones? Hormones actually, these are the chemical substances, these are the chemical messengers, these are the informational molecules which are secreted by endocrine glands into the blood and for controlling the and coordinating the activities of various body organs. This is the definition of hormones. And usually the first hormone that was named as the secretin, that was discovered by the two scientists in the year 1902. Those were named as the Bayliss and Starling. ये जो पहला हार्मोन दैट इज द सेक्रेटिन, ये दो साइंटिस्ट ने डिस्कवर किया था. द फर्स्ट वाज नेम्ड एज द बेलिसिस एंड द सेकंड साइंटिस्ट नेम्ड एज स्टार्लिंग इन द ईयर 1902. एंड द टर्म हार्मोन वाज कॉइन्ड बाय द सेम साइंटिस्ट दैट इज द स्टार्लिंग इन द ईयर 1905. दिस इज लिटिल बिट अबाउट द हार्मोन्स. व्हाट आर द हार्मोन्स? Which was the first hormone, and who discovered the first hormone, and who coined the term hormone? That was little bit about the hormones. Moving back to our the topic, that is the endocrine system or endocrine glands. There are number of endocrine glands present in our body which togetherly form the endocrine system. Like the number of endocrine glands and their location, that is shown in the diagram. The first gland here is, that is the hypothalamus, and the second gland located in the brain. The second gland, that is known as the pituitary gland, that is also located in the brain. Third gland, that is the pineal gland, that is also located inside the brain. The next gland, that is known as the thyroid gland, its location, its position is shown in the diagram. That is also located in the thyroid, that is located in the neck region, in the throat region. After that, four glands, they are known as the parathyroid glands. Those are also located in the neck region. After that, coming down downwards in our body, the thymus gland that is present also near our heart. After that, the next gland, those are known as the adrenal glands. These adrenal glands are present on the upper side of each kidney. Those are known as adrenal glands. And then pancreas, this is another endocrine gland that is present between the stomach and the intestines. That is the endocrine gland. After that, the next gland, that though in case of males, those are the testes, and in case of females, the ovaries, they act as the endocrine glands. And all these glands togetherly form the endocrine system. Talking about the first gland, that is known as the hypothalamus. The diagram of the hypothalamus is shown here. And here, what is the hypothalamus? We have already studied this hypothalamus in the nervous system as a part of brain. It contains various nervous centers, and it is meant for controlling the various activities of our body. Besides having the nervous centers, the hypothalamus, it also acts as an endocrine gland. You saw here hypothalamus چھُ اکھ ہسا چھُ یہِ نٔروَس سینٹر واریاہ کَنٹین کران. اَمہِ علاوٕ ہسا چھُ اَتھ منٛز آسان دَ اِٹ کَن اِٹ سیکریٹس دَ کیمِکل سبسٹنسز نون ایز ہارمونز سو اِٹ آلسو ایکٹس ایز اے اینڈوکراین گلینڈ اینڈ ہیر وی ہیو ٹو سٹڈی دا اینڈوکراین فنکشن آف دَ ہایپوتھیلمس اینڈ یُس ہسا یہِ ہایپوتھیلمس چھُ ویر اِز دَ لوکیشن اِٹ اِز لوکیٹِڈ in the forebrain and the last part of the forebrain that is known as diencephalon and at the base of the diencephalon. For example, this is the diencephalon and here this is the base of diencephalon. Here is the location of the hypothalamus. The hypothalamus lies at the base, yeah, we can see floor of the diencephalon, and this hypothalamus helps in the secretion of the two types of hormones. It secretes two types of hormones. The first type of hormones released by the hypothalamus are releasing hormones, shortly abbreviated as RH. The next type of hormones secreted by the hypothalamus, they are known as inhibiting. Inhibiting means which stop, inhibiting, which prevent, inhibiting hormones, shortly abbreviated as the IH. These are the two types of hormones which are secreted by the hypothalamus. And now, what is the releasing hormones and the inhibiting hormones, both these hormones, they actually control the secretions of the next gland that is known as the pituitary gland. And what is the function of these very releasing hormones? And the releasing hormones, these are secreted by the hypothalamus into the blood, and after that the releasing hormones reach to the pituitary gland where they lead to the secretion pituitary gland and where they lead to the secretion of the various hormones of the pituitary gland. Pituitary gland jo hota hai bahut sare hormones secrete karta hai, but ye tab tak wo hormones secrete nahi karega jab tak ki ये हाइपोथैलेमस से इंफॉर्मेशन आएगी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ रिलीजिंग हार्मोन. व्हेन एवर द हाइपोथैलेमस सेंड्स द पर्टिकुलर टाइप ऑफ रिलीजिंग हार्मोन टू द पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड एंड द पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड सेक्रेट्स द रेस्पेक्टिव हार्मोन इनटू द ब्लड फॉर कंट्रोलिंग द वेरियस एक्टिविटीज ऑफ अवर बॉडी. एंड द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ द वेरियस रिलीजिंग हार्मोन्स आर लाइक देयर इज द थायराइड स्टिमुलेटिंग हार्मोन रिलीजिंग हार्मोन. This thyroid stimulating hormone, this is the actually the hormone which is secreted by the pituitary gland, but pituitary gland secretes only the thyroid stimulating hormone whenever it receives the hormone, that is the thyroid stimulating hormone, the releasing hormone from the hypothalamus, and then there will be the release of the hormones that is known as the thyroid stimulating hormone. So on, there are number of hormones which are secreted by the pituitary gland, and for every hormone there is a particular type of releasing hormone which is secreted by the hypothalamus into the blood. After that, the inhibiting hormone. Now inhibiting hormones are also the hormones secreted by the hypothalamus into the blood, and they reach to the pituitary gland, same gland. And what is the function of inhibiting hormones? ये inhibiting hormones क्या करते हैं? जो पहला वाला hormone वो हर किसी या pituitary gland को कराता था secretion, मगर ये जो inhibiting hormones, it helps in the stopping of the secretion of the various hormones of the respective hormones of the pituitary gland. It leads to the stoppage, yeah, it inhibits, yeah, it prevents the secretions of the hormones by the pituitary gland. This also reaches to the pituitary gland, and pituitary gland then stops the secretion of that very type of hormone into the blood by the help of inhibiting hormone. These are the two hormones. Besides that, the hypothalamus, the neurons present in the hypothalamus, they also produce two types of hormones. The first one is known as oxytocin, and the second type of hormone that is known as the vasopressin, yeah, that is also known as the antidiuretic hormone. These two types of hormones are also produced by the neurons. They are actually known as neurohormones, and into the blood, but they are stored in the pituitary gland, which we will study after that. And the pituitary gland, then we have to study that those two types of hormones in the topic, that is the pituitary gland. After that, we will study the next, yeah, start the next gland that is known as the pituitary gland. दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट द हाइपोथैलेमस. आफ्टर दैट वी विल स्टडी, हम जो स्टार्ट करने जा रहे हैं दूसरा ग्लैंड, उसको हम बोलते हैं पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड. एंड एज मेंशनड अर्लियर द पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड, एज यू नो दिस इज द ग्लैंड दैट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज द मास्टर ग्लैंड, या इट्स अनदर नेम इज दिस इज ऑल्सो नेम्ड एज हाइपोफाइसिस. This is also known as hypophysis. And pituitary gland, this is master gland. The pituitary, what is the location of this pituitary gland? As shown in the diagram, this is also present in the brain and it hangs below the hypothalamus by a stalk-like structure. That stalk-like structure is known as infundibulum. Infundibulum, stalk. Stalk means in the sense tail-like structure, that is known as infundibulum. यहाँ पे भी हम डायग्राम बनाएंगे. This is the infundibulum and this is the structure by which the this is the pituitary gland, this is the stalk-like structure. This is known as infundibulum. And the this is the trilobar structure. This is known as pituitary gland, which is present in the at the base of the hypothalamus. And this pituitary gland rests in a cavity of our brain that is known as sella turcica. ये जो pituitary gland होता है, ये brain की एक cavity में present होता है. That cavity of the brain is known as sella turcica. Now moving on to the structure of the pituitary gland, as I said, this is a trilobar structure. The first lobe is known as the anterior lobe. This is the first lobe is known as anterior lobe. Then the second lobe, trilobar means it is having three chambers, three compartments. The first lobe is known as anterior lobe. The second one is known as the middle lobe. Middle one, and the last lobe, last compartment, it is known as the posterior lobe. Pituitary gland में तीन compartments होती हैं, three chambers होते हैं. पहले chamber को हम बोलेंगे anterior lobe, anterior pituitary lobe. The second one is known as the middle pituitary lobe, and the third one is known as the posterior pituitary lobe. And the all the three lobes, they secrete a number of hormones. Like with anterior lobe, it secretes its hormones. The middle lobe secreted its hormones, and the posterior lobe that also secretes its hormone. Now we will be discussing about the hormones of the anterior pituitary lobe, yeah, anterior lobe of pituitary gland, anterior lobe, and the this very anterior lobe of the pituitary gland that secretes six or seven types of hormones that are shown in this very diagram. The first type of the hormone that is secreted by the pituitary gland, that is known as the follicle stimulating hormone. The another type of hormone that is known as the adrenocorticotropic hormone. Third type of hormone, ACTH shortly named as, the third type of hormone that is known as the luteinizing hormone. After that, the next hormone that is known as thyroid stimulating hormone. Then the next hormone that is known as prolactin. These are the various hormones which are secreted by the this very pituitary gland, yeah, anterior lobe of pituitary gland, yeah. And I will give a formula to remember easily these very five types of hormones. You have to just remember a word that is known as phallus, F-A-L-L-S-E, phallus teaching practice. This is the easy way to remember the various hormones of the anterior lobe of pituitary gland. Phallus means, we can say, F stands for follicle stimulating hormone, will be discussed later on. Adrenocorticotropic hormone, this is the luteinizing hormone. This is the somatotropic hormone. E we have to omit, it is just meant for making a word. After that, T stands for the thyroid stimulating hormone. And the last P, that is known as prolactin, that stands for prolactin. These are the six types of hormones which are secreted by the anterior lobe of pituitary gland. Now starting the first hormone, that is known as follicle stimulating hormone, shortly abbreviated as the FSH, follicle stimulating hormone. and this is very much easy. Its function is very much easy to remember because its name indicates its function. Huh? This follicle stimulating hormone is secreted by the anterior lobe of pituitary gland, both in case of males as well as females. And in males, it performs one function, and in females, it performs another function. Huh? In females and in males. And now the question arises, what is the function of the FSH in case of males and in case of females? In females, what it does, the follicle stimulating hormone is secreted by anterior lobe into the blood, and it reaches into the ovaries, where it performs what? It helps in the stimulation of, yeah, it stimulates the growth of ovarian follicles and release of estrogen from them. This is the first function of the, is the function of the follicle stimulating hormone in case of females. In females, simply it stimulates. Firstly, it is a hormone, and as you know, as I described earlier, that, yeah, what do we mean by hormone? This is a hormone. Then it stimulates what? It stimulates follicles. That is why this is known as follicle stimulating hormone. Huh? It stimulates the growth of ovarian follicles and the release of estrogen from them. This is the function of the follicle stimulating hormone in case of females. Huh? And now what the question arises, what do we mean by the follicles? Follicles, what are the follicles? And if we take the female reproductive system, in female reproductive system, there are the primary sex organs, which are known as the ovaries. These ovaries, inside the ovaries, there are a number of eggs, but yeah, number of ovum, we can say ova, right from the birth, and those ova are present in the ovary, but in the sac-like structure, in the fluid-filled sacs, and those fluid-filled sacs, sac means the, we can say, bag-like structures, and these follicles are known as the ovarian follicles. Samjhaya ki follicle ka chisma, this is the follicle, these are the various follicles, ovarian follicles. Follicles are actually, they are the bag, fluid-filled, imon fluid asan present, and fluid-filled bag-like structure an chisma, these are known as ovarian follicles. Ovaries in manchasan, ovarian follicle, and ovarian follicle and underkin hasachasan, the structures which are known as eggs. But eggs are in immature form. Kimchin mature asan, again, they are unable to perform the, unable to fertilize because they are immature. Huh? And now, when a female attains puberty, the follicle stimulating hormones are produced by the anterior lobe, they are released into the blood, they reach to the ovaries. And in the ovaries, what they perform, they help in the growth of the certain follicles. Jim hasa ovary mas ke follicles chasan, iman follicle and his growth chim karan taaki, yus hasa iman mas egg should be ready, yasa gas ready gasun for the process of fertilization. Is the kya shikasan kaum, yim hasa growth of follicles chikasan, that occurs by the follicle stimulating hormone. Yim satan growth of follicle gasan, iman follicle mas hasa chu, asan egg stimon, egg san jasa chu growth gasan by the help of follicle stimulating hormone. And that is the secondary question. Only one of the follicle that attains maturity, one of the egg attains maturity during every month of the 28 days. That is the secondary question. But start, we just problem the function of the FSH. After that, I want to go to the function of the egg. And the functions of estrogen will be dealt when we will study about the ovaries as the endocrine glands. Huh? Yeah, so go about the follicle stimulating hormone. And one shows in case of males. Males and must kya kaam shukaran kus, the follicle stimulating hormone. In males, it is also released by the anterior lobe of pituitary gland into the blood. But here it reaches it reaches near to the testes. Yeah, so testes and vatan, and in testes it leads to the formation of the sperms. Yeah, so formation of sperms. Go sperms will not be formed until the testes of the human male body, they will receive the follicle stimulating hormone. Which can have such karan. The next hormone of the anterior lobe of pituitary gland, that is known as adrenocorticotropic hormone. It is very much difficult to pronounce, but it is very much easy. The adrenocorticotropic hormone, this is the second hormone of the pituitary gland. And what is the function of this very adrenocorticotropic hormone? This hormone that is secreted by the pituitary gland into the blood, and it reaches to the glands which are known as the adrenal glands, which are located on the upper side of each kidney. They are known as adrenal glands. These are two in number, and these adrenal glands secrete, they reach this adrenocorticotropic hormone reaches to the adrenal gland, and it stimulates the adrenal gland, adrenal cortex part of the adrenal gland to release its hormones. Adrenocorticotropic hormone, because yeah, such a hormone, yeah, such adrenal cortexes stimulate karan ki ce kar sa pani hormones release. Jut kal karne adrenal cortex pani hormones release ke, yut kal nasa otan tamat vaati adrenocorticotropic hormone. Much matlab, what do you mean by the adrenal cortex? It can is for you in case of brain. The brain is having the outer part that is known as the outer cortex, and the inner part that is known as the inner medulla. It can use outer one was gray matter, inner one was the white matter. It can erase pneumonia adrenal gland. Adrenal gland is also its outer part. The outer part is known as the outer cortex. Yeah, this is also known as the outer. This is also known as the adrenal cortex. And the inner part of the adrenal gland is known as adrenal medulla. Yeah, this is simply known as the inner medulla. And both the adrenal cortex, it secretes different types of hormones, and adrenal medulla, this secretes different types of hormones. But adrenal cortex secretes only hormones when it receives the information from the pituitary gland in the form of adrenocorticotropic hormone. Our samaj hormone kya ishu, this is by hormone is definition one is already. Adrenocorticotropic kya ishu, because yeah, so adreno stands for adrenal, and corticotropic means it's stimulates the cortex part of the adrenal gland, not medulla part of the adrenal gland. That is why this is known as adrenocorticotropic hormone. This is the second hormone. And after that, the next hormone that is produced by the anterior lobe of pituitary gland, that is known as luteinizing hormone, LH. That is the luteinizing hormone. And this luteinizing hormone is secreted in the blood by the anterior pituitary lobe, and it reaches to the ovaries in case of females, and in case of males it reaches to the testes. And in females, what is the function of this very luteinizing hormone? In females, it stimulates the process that is known as the, it leads to a process that is known as ovulation and the release of progesterone from the structure that is known as corpus luteum. So one is going to go the sukiago for ovulation. Usually in the menstrual cycle of a female, during the middle of the menstrual cycle, during the 14th to 16th day, the egg that gets released from the ovary into the fallopian tube, and that process that by which the mature egg, which was developed by the help of the follicle stimulating hormone, you saw so mature egg grew mature because of the follicle stimulating hormone, and at maturity you saw say egg so was present in the developing follicle, in the growing follicle, and I'm growing follicle was the egg narrow never yeah ovary must egg narrow never into the fallopian tube of the female reproductive system. This process is known as ovulation. And ovulation kya is gasa, so that the egg might be ready to get fertilized. So yeah, so fertilization khatra tayar rozan tawai hasu egg neran from the ovaries into the fallopian tube. And this process of ovulation, that is the release of egg from the mature follicle, from the ovary into the fallopian tube, is known as ovulation. And this ovulation occurs because of the luteinizing hormone. Samajhayman? And after that one is next function, LH. Ke, LH has to help karan in the release of another female sex hormone that is known as progesterone. Huh? And but from the structure that is known as corpus luteum. Usually corpus kachisman, usually at least English to Urdu meaning one. Corpus stands for lash. Lash is chasan, that means ruh, yim satan insanas near anchu. I just put structure by jo, thirdly body by ki, ruh varai tachisman, that is known as satasachisman lash, itakanchi, that is known as corpus, itakanchi, yetente corpus luteum. You saw say follicle asanchu, ya growing follicle chasan, atmosu developing egg chasan mindo, egg follicle along with the egg, yasachak zin the body mindo, and once yim satan egg release gasanchu, ruh yim satan imskosh, but nearest salanchu, so asachu watan into the. Into the fallopian tube, and yes, you can structure root empty follicle. We can say, yet empty follicle without the egg. This is known as corpus luteum. Simple to ISL, this is known as corpus luteum. Go corpus luteum, yes, such a large as that means without egg, you saw empty follicle when by chance inside the ovaries. And this is known as corpus luteum. And the corpus luteum has such karan kaam, secrete karan a hormone, that is known as the progesterone. Magli was a the LH function of LH in case of females. Much muscle in males. Males and must have kaam shukaran. Males and must have such karan kaam, this luteinizing hormone is secreted by the pituitary gland into the blood, and it reaches to the testes, yes, so testes and tamath vatan, and there in testes there are special cells, they are known as Leydig cells. Leydig cells, and even Leydig cells and hasashi kaam karnavan, even hasashi karnavan secrete the hormone that is known as male sex hormone, that is known as testosterone. Go in males, in the males, the luteinizing hormone that stimulates the Leydig cells to secrete the male sex hormone that is known as testosterone. Huh? Yes, it's true. And in males, yes, ICSH, interstitial cell stimulating hormone. Interstitial cell stimulating hormone. In case of the males, it reaches to the testes and stimulates the Leydig cells, special type of cells present in the testes, to produce the male sex hormone that is known as testosterone. And this was about the next gland that is known as the luteinizing hormone. After that, the next hormone that is produced by the anterior lobe of pituitary gland, fourth hormone rather, that is known as, one more thing, you saw a follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone together, they are known as gonadotropic hormones. Gonadotropic hormones, gonadotropic hormones, in case of both these hormones, the FSH that acts on the testes and ovaries, LH, it also acts on the testes and ovaries, and as you know, testes and ovaries, they are also known as gonads because they help in the production of the germ cells, and that is why they are known as the gonads. And yim dhanwai hasach karan act on gonads, that is the testes and ovaries, tawashiman collectively vyaknavananas follicle stimulating hormones, the luteinizing hormones, just vyaknavanan together, they are known as the gonadotropic hormones. So after that, which is next type of hormone, that is known as the growth hormone. Yeah, we can say somatotropic hormones. Somatotropic hormone. This is the next hormone which is present, which is secreted by the, this is also known as the growth hormone, which is secreted by the anterior lobe of pituitary gland. And what is the function? As the name indicates, it stimulates that it is responsible for the growth of our body, growth of the animal body. That is why this is known as growth hormone, STH, somatotropic hormone. Huh? And how it performs, it increases the growth of an organism. It just simply increases the rate of anabolism. Anabolism stress already put. Yeah, such anabolic reactions, anabolism rate increase karan. Yeah, it leads to the growth of muscles, particularly muscles. It leads to the growth of muscles. It leads to the growth of the bones, huh? And also it retains the maximum calcium in our body. That is how this hormone helps in increasing the growth of our body. Huh? This is the function of this very hormone that is known as the somatotropic hormone. One muscle, because in sans muscle has such hyper secretion. Hyper means the high secretion. Hyper was other. Hyper secretion means over secretion of the hormone. ہسا چھِ گژھان ییٚمہِ ساتہٕ کٲنٛسہِ اِنسانَس منٛز ہسا چھِ لۄکچار پٮ۪ٹھٕے ہایپَر سیکریشَن گژھان نٔتیٖجہٕ چھُ نیران یہِ کہِ أمِس منٛز گژھِ گرٛوتھ زیادٕ ییٚمہِ ساتہٕ گرٛوتھ گژھِ زیادٕ دیٹ میٖنٕز أہٕنٛز باڈی ہُنٛد سایز گژھِ واریاہ زیادٕ اِنکریٖز اینٛڈ تَتھ أمِس گژھِ اَکھ ڈِس آرڈَر دیٹ اِز نون ایز گِگینٹِزٕم گِگینٹِزٕم میٖنٕز جینٛٹ لایک یِہوٚے جِن ہیوٗ ہسا باسہِ گِگینٹِزٕم ہسا باسہِ اِنسان گِگینٹِزٕم ہسا چھِ گژھِ أمِس اینٛڈ گِگینٹِزٕم ہسا گوٚو سُہ ڈِس آرڈَر ییٚمہِ ساتہٕ أکِس اِنسانَس یا آرگَنِزمَس باڈی ہِنٛز ہایٹ نارمَل کھۄتہٕ واریاہ زیادٕ اِنکریٖز گژھِ دیٹ جینٛٹ لایک اپیرَنٕس گژھٮ۪س دیٹ اِز نون ایز گِگینٹِزٕم اینٛڈ دِس گِگینٹِزٕم اِز کازٕڈ بِکاز آف دَ اوٚوَر سیکریشَن یا ہایپَر سیکریشَن آف دَ ہارمون دیٹ اِز نون ایز سومیٹوٹرٛاپِک ہارمون یا گرٛوتھ ہارمون ہاں وۄنۍ اگر أسۍ اَمیُک اَپوزِٹ وٕچھو اگرے وۄنۍ سومیٹوٹرٛاپِک ہارمون یا گرٛوتھ ہارمون کَم سیکریٹ گژھِ دیٹ میٖنٕز ہایپو سیکریشَن یا لیس سیکریشَن ہایپو ہایپو میٖنٕز کَم ہاں ہایپو سیکریشَن آف دَ گرٛوتھ ہارمون دیٹ آلسو رِزَلٹٕس اِن اَ ڈِس آرڈَر دیٹ اِز نون ایز دَ ڈوارفِزٕم اَمہِ ساتَن ہَسا ییٚمِس اِنسانَس منٛز یہِ کَم سیکریٹ گژھِ تٔمِس ہَسا گژھِ بیٛاکھ اَکھ ڈِس آرڈَر تٔمِس گژھِ نہٕ برابر گرٛوتھ کِہیٖنۍ تہٕ اس لیے ہسا روزِ تُہُنٛد سٹیچَر ہا دَ سٹیچَر آف دیٹ پٔرسَن وِل بی رِمین ویری شاٹ سُہ ہسا روزِ ژھوٚٹ اینٛڈ تَتھ ڈِس آرڈرَس تہِ وَنۍ دیٹ اِز نون ایز ڈوارفِزٕم وۄنۍ چھُ مسلہٕ کانٛہہ اِنسان ہسا چھُ ایڈَلٹہُڈَس تامَتھ ہسا گوٚو کٲم أمِس أمِس ہسا گوٚو نارمَل سیکریشَن دیٹ میٖنٕز نہ گوٚو أمِس گِگینٹِزٕم نہ گوٚو ڈوارفِزٕم مگر اگر أمِس ہایپَر سیکریشَن گژھِ اِن دَ اولڈ ایج یا اِن دَ کیٛاہ چھِ وَنان میچوَر یا ایڈَلٹٕس وٕنکٮ۪ن اِن دَ میچوَر سٹیج میچوَر سٹیجَس منٛز اگرے ہسا أمِس وۄنۍ یہِ ہایپَر سیکریشَن گژھِ أمِس ہسا چھُ اَکھ ڈِس آرڈَر گژھان دیٹ ڈِس آرڈَر اِز نون ایز ایکرومِگیلی دیٹ میٖنٕز گۄڈنٮ۪تھٕے ہسا آسہِ أمِس باڈی ہِنٛز ہایٹ آسہِ أمِس نارمَل تہٕ نہ آسہِ ڈوارٕف نہ آسہِ جیٖن مگر اگرے أسۍ منٛزَے أمِس گٔے کہِ سیکریشَن ہایپَر سیکریشَن أمِس گژھِ بیٛاکھ اَکھ ڈِس آرڈَر تَتھ چھِ أسۍ وَنان ایکرومِگیلی ایکرومِگیلی منٛز چھُنہٕ اِنکریٖز اِن ہایٹ گژھان کینٛہہ ہِیَر وَٹ اَکٕز ہِیَر دیر اِز دَ اِنکریٖز اِن دَ سایز آف دَ بونٕز آف دَ فیٖٹ یا بونٕز آف دَ فیٖٹ یا بونٕز آف دَ ہینٛڈٕز یا بونٕز آف دَ فیس یَتھ منٛز ہسا چھِ أکِس اِنسانَس یِم کھۄر چھِ تِم چھِ واریاہ بٔڑۍ گژھان اینٛڈ یِم ہسا اَتھ چھِ تِم تہِ ہسا چھِ واریاہ زیٹھان بِکاز یِہنٛدٮ۪ن اَمہِ کٮ۪ن یِم اَتھ منٛز بونٕز چھِ آسان تِمن بونزن ہِنٛز ہسا چھِ گژھان ایبنارمل گروتھ اینٛڈ بیٚیہِ ہسا چھُ فیسٕچ یِم بونٕز چھِ تِمن تہِ ہسا چھِ گژھان کٲم تِمن تہِ ہسا چھِ اِنکریٖز اِن سایز گژھان نٔتیٖجہٕ چھُ نیران أمِس اِنسانَس تہِ ہسا چھُ بُتھ تہِ واریاہ زیادٕ بوٚڑ گژھان اینٛڈ تَتھ ڈِس آرڈرس چھِ أسۍ وَنان دیٹ اِز نون ایز ایکرومِگیلی ہاں دِس اِز ایباؤٹ دَ نیکسٹ ہارمون دیٹ اِز نون ایز دَ سومیٹوٹرٛاپِک ہارمون آفٹر دیٹ دَ لاسٹ ہارمون دیٹ اِز دَ پرٛولیکٹِن دَ فنٛکشَن آف پرٛولیکٹِن اِز دَ پرٛولیکٹِن دِس اِز آلسو نون ایز دَ میٹرنِٹی ہارمون اینٛڈ دِس ہارمون اِز آلسو سیکریٹِڈ باے دَ اینٹیٖریَر لوب آف پِچوٹری گلینٛڈ اینٛڈ وَٹ اِز دَ فنٛکشَن آف پرٛولیکٹِن اِٹ ہیلپٕس اِن دَ گرٛوتھ آف میمری گلینٛڈٕز جوٗرِنٛگ دَ پرٛیگنَنسی میمری گلینٛڈٕز during the pregnancy and also it helps in a process that is known as lactation that means the production of milk from the mammary glands in case of female this is the function of the hormone that is known as the prolactin and last kind of hormone the next kind of hormone that is known as the thyroid stimulating hormone thyroid TSH the last hormone which is secreted by the anterior lobe of pituitary gland is known as the thyroid stimulating hormone that is the TSH and simple this hormone that helps in the that stimulates the this the hormone that stimulates the thyroid gland to produce and release its hormone that is why this is known as thyroid stimulating hormone huh? Without the thyroid stimulating hormone the thyroid gland this thyroid gland cannot secrete its hormone so the for secretion of hormones by the thyroid gland which is present inside our throat region the thyroid gland receives information in the form of thyroid stimulating hormone which is secreted from by the anterior lobe of pituitary gland into the blood and this is the last hormone that is secreted by the anterior lobe of the pituitary gland that is all about the hormones of the anterior lobe of pituitary gland thanks